Going on in the market today? What is the concern that's driving the markets lower?
So I think, you know, you guys have been talking about it. It's a combination of the two things that are coming to a head. So we had the fear of the virus, and now you've got the interest rate potential movement up. It's definitely with the taper. So both sides of the, you know, of the barbell, where if you were value and cyclical and you were growth, are both getting hurt at this point. And to us, you know, the Fed is seeing something. Now put the virus aside, the Fed is seeing higher growth than they expected. They're seeing higher inflation than they expected. And for that, meaning even if things slow down a little bit, they can still taper and the economy can then survive along with higher earnings. And earnings is going to drive the stock market. And I think that's what's going to push us into kind of keeping where we are, if not higher, for the next 6 months to a year in the stock market.
Has anything changed, Sarat, in your view of how you position yourself, given what the Fed has said, and knowing that in the next few weeks we're going to know much, much more about Omicron and the trajectory of that virus and the efficacy of the vaccines and treatments? In the next few weeks, we might get some more insight on who will fill various vacant Fed seats around the country and at the Federal Reserve. I'm wondering, just, you know, to what extent are you certain in how you're positioned right now, given the unknowns?
So, you know, I think we were positioned to be more reopening. And this is definitely kind of a pullback that has hurt some of the positions that we own. I do still think, given if the virus is contained, that is the strategy going forward. If you look at what rates are going to do to value stocks, what they're going to do to financials, if you look at reopening for transports, that's kind of the place you want to be. Especially given how hot this economy is with rising prices and interest rates moving up. Now, where we have to be careful is if rates move up too fast, you know, what is that going to do to some parts of the sector, especially the growthy sectors? And I think, you know, we've been talking about this for a while. You have to be really careful. Your cash flows want to be now. They don't want to be in the future. And I think today you've got that condition where potentially you have some of the high valuation stocks coming down, not because they're not growing. It's just because of more of a valuation call.
Did Powell surprise you this morning? And if so, are you taking any action in response?
So I'm not taking any action in response. I was a little surprised given where we were with the virus. But, you know, some of the when they're ready to talk, they've already got some of these pre-planned speeches. So the question will be in the next couple of weeks, as we get more information, does the playbook change? Does Powell and team actually then say, hey, things were better or worse? Or are they confident that the economy can still be as robust given kind of what's going on with some of the virus information we're getting?
You actually brought stock picks, Sarat, and on a day like today, we don't often get to them. But Charter Communications and Uber, they seem curious, maybe is the word, for a day like today when we're seeing a lot of pressure, especially Uber, on higher valuation, unprofitable
right.
names.
So Uber is an interesting play. I mean, it is a stock that everybody loves to hate just because it's a reopening story. The management is committed to being free cash flow positive. They've gotten rid of all their businesses that don't lose money. So they're in rides, they're in freight, and they're in Eats. Now, if the virus does come back and it's pretty strong, that could hurt them. But if things are kind of base case, this is a company that's really going to benefit, especially if people start traveling, people start going back to work, people are living in hybrid. So, and I think that's another reason for Charter as well. Charter does really well in a hybrid environment because people will pay more for broadband. And that's a huge cash flow company that has steady growth rates. So I think that the combination of those two, now having said in a steady economy with rising inflation, these two will do quite well.
Sarat, thank you so much. Sarat Sethi, DCLA.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.